pleasure meeting Pastor Kevin just a few minutes ago in Fellowship Hall. And I grew up down here at Manchester United Methodist, back when Al Michener was the pastor there. Remember Pastor Al, and then I think John Ward took his place, but I grew up out here in Ballwin, and we're living out in the middle of nowhere now where Moses left his shoes. But this is my family, and good to have our boy back with us. He lives up here, so he doesn't play with us regular, but since this is right around the corner, we just had to have him, so that's good. I'll introduce him as we go along, but let's get Emily up. We're in the key of A, so let's open up with a good one. She'll do one entitled Overcomer. One, two.
People drive by, T-Mac on the radio. Got so much on your mind, nothing's really going right. Looking for a radio.
Yeah.
Hey. Thank you so much. Need to introduce my crew to you. I think some of y'all may have met them beforehand, but these are my daughters right here. This is Emily on the guitar and Brooke on the dobro. How about a hand for the girls? And they're twins. They don't look anything alike, do they? But they're fraternal twins, so we've enjoyed raising all our kids, and I'm just tickled Owen could join us. He's our second oldest, and he's been living up here now, what, about a year and a half, 2 years, something like that? And he and his wife are giving us our first grandchild. So, but Hannah and Noah couldn't make it today, but Owen's here. So how about a hand for Owen? I remember back in the day, Owen picked these shoes out back when we all traveled as a family. He was 12 or 13, and man, you could not outdress him. He'd hit all the thrift stores and get the loudest clothing possible. But I miss you, son. I'm glad you could sit in with us today. Yeah, he had a blue jacket that was sequined, and anyway, looked like Porter Wagner. This is my lovely bride right here. Everybody thinks I'm her dad, but this is my wife. Every man needs a good woman, amen? I'm a few years older than her. I've got all the gray hair, and she's got all the good looks. This is Bobette.
And since you mentioned the bride thing, we were on our way up here, and he says, looky there, girls, look, that little chapel right there, that's where we got married. And I'm going, that's not where we got married. I wanted to ask for details.
Well, my mother's memorial service was down there in the Manchester UMC chapel. I don't know how I get those two mixed up. But well, leave it to good old dad to get things balled up. All right, let's get Mom to sing one right now. And I'm going to send this out to our brother Kevin Thoney. Kevin's a good friend of ours, and we played down at the family camp that he ramrods down in, boy, that's really in the middle of nowhere. It's down at Dora, Missouri, about, what, 30, 40 miles west of West Plains. And a lot of good folks down there. We've been coming down there to the family camp several years. So glad to have you with us, Kevin. And we'll send this out to you. I know you're a Bible believer, so this is what this song is all about. What a title, I Believe.
Dwells within us, the heavenly Father is above. I believe in the blessing hope.
This next song is one that Michael W. Smith wrote. Now, y'all familiar with Michael W. Smith? Well-known name in gospel music, right? Well, I'll tell you, I probably listened to way too much talk radio, not enough music radio, and I didn't know who the name Michael Smith was. I should have, but I just didn't. And just seemed like when I was a teenager, I listened to music all the time on the radio. I don't know, as you get older, you get concerned about all sorts of stuff. It doesn't matter, but... we worked this song up. Emily brought it into the band. She's going to sing it. And it's a song that Michael W. Smith wrote. And it's called Sky Spills Over. So we worked up the song and been performing it for a few months. And we decided to go ahead and record it on a CD. Well, we're also on a TV show called Great American Gospel. I don't know if any of y'all have ever watched that. But they filmed us doing the song and put it out on the TV show. Well, Michael W. Smith saw us doing his song on the TV. And he sent us a real complimentary email, and thank you so much. Y'all sound great doing the song, and good luck to you. And I didn't know who he was. I got the email, and I thought it was somebody we might have met out of the church the week before or something. So was that me? I'm getting the story mixed up.
I responded to him, but I too didn't know who he was.
Well, okay, yeah. So anyway, I came out in the living room, said, just got an email. I sent an answer back. From a guy named Michael W. Smith. Why does that name sound familiar? And the girls were like, oh, you know who Michael W. Smith is? And they explained it to us. So Bobette went back in and emailed him back. What did you say in that second email?
I said, I'm so sorry, but my husband had no idea who you were.
Dad got thrown under the bus again, right? Okay, well, let's go ahead and do this song. One entitled, Sky Spills Over. One, two, one, two, three. 2009, the girls were, seemed like you were 7 or 8, and we traveled all around with our family, and I'll tell you, we really have a heart for family bands. I've sat and watched family bands with tears in my eyes. I mean, they don't have to get up and quote scripture or say one word about God. Just the fact that they're on stage singing and playing gospel music as a family, it just speaks volumes, you know. But then when scripture is quoted or the word is preached a little bit, why, it just does wonders. I really believe family bands have a ministry. And you know, our kids are all grown up now. Family bands have a season, so we don't play so much anymore. We do locally, but we don't travel so much anymore. But we put on a family music festival down at our place in Fredericktown every year in September. And we're going into our sixth annual, and it's growing. Black River's bringing us another 400 amps of electric. We've got RV hookups, so we're going to be doubling in size on RV hookups. And we have, I don't know, 300 or 400 people that come out there and have a whole weekend full of music, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and it's always the last weekend of September. You have flyers out at the CD table? Okay, good. I hope you do. So if you feel so inclined, pick one up. We'd love to have you join us in September. You know, when we were traveling... Yeah, it is on our website, thepunches.net, no, .org. Okay, I can't keep all this straight. Years ago, we went up to Washington, D.C. and got to stay in the Watergate Hotel. Y'all familiar with the legacy that place left behind? Y'all remember Watergate. I know you do. Well, we got checked in there and got in our room, and I was almost asleep, and Bobette rolled over, and she said, "Do you reckon this place is bugged?" Well, the more I laid there and thought about it, the more it bothered me. I got up and I looked everywhere. I couldn't find a doggone thing. But on the way back to bed, I spotted a little bitty throw rug out in the middle of the floor. I kicked it back. And underneath there was a tiny metal plate about that big, and it had two screws in it. Well, I took the screws up, looked under the metal plate, and there was nothing there either. So I put it all back together and went on to bed and had a good night's sleep. The next morning, I went down to the front desk to check out, and the clerk said, "Mr. Punches, how was your stay here at our hotel?" I said, "Well, everything was just first class. Why do you ask?" He said, "Well, I guess you didn't hear about the couple down in the room below you, did you?" I said, "No, sir, I didn't." He said, "A chandelier fell on them in the middle of the night." I'll tell you, with families, things can sure get interesting real quick. Y'all have raised families. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Well, let's get Bob Ethicum on right out of the Bible when God told Elijah to go stay by the brook. That's what this song is all about. One entitled "Stay by the Brook." One, two, three.
Just as God did for Elijah, he will do for me and you. Stay by the brook, stay by the brook. God told Elijah to go there, stay by the brook. I'll sing to your prayer beneath, ribbons bring you food to me. Don't be faint-hearted, just look to me. Stay by the brook. Yeah.
We appreciate the invite up here. Thank you so much. Again, a beautiful day, beautiful church. Just good to be with y'all on a sunny Sunday. Let's get Brooke to take us out on this part. I think we'll come back and do another tune or two.
If you want to, we'll let you.
Pardon me?
If you want to, we'll let you.
Yeah, we'll sure do it. We'll just set in like a long rain. Y'all will be tired of us by the time this is all over. But let's get Brooke to take us out on one that the Inspirations did back in 1969. The Inspirations, a Southern Gospel Quartet. They put out a lot of good tunes. So let's have her throw down on one entitled The Walls of Jericho. One, two, three.